Hello students, good afternoon. Today we learn about Primary Education Act 1926. Okay, so here our main focus points are: what is the Primary Education Act? Okay, secondly, what are the main features of the act? Okay, so here the marks already given, so I think you do not have any problem with this because already marks are given. So let's continue the class with the main first point, that is, what is the Primary Education Act 1926. Okay, so here, because of Gopal Krishna Gokhale's effort of making primary education compulsory, several primary education acts were passed in various provinces for making primary education compulsory. As such, the first Primary Education Act, Assam, was passed in 1926 to provide facilities for the introduction of compulsory primary education in Assam. This act is known as Primary Education Act of Assam. Okay, so because of Gopal Krishna Gokhale's effort for making primary education compulsory, different types of Primary Education Act was passed in India to make the primary education compulsory for Indian people. Okay, as such, the first primary education in Assam was passed in the year 1926 to provide facilities for the introduction of primary education compulsory in Assam. So this is the act which is known as Primary Education Act of Assam. In the year 1926, this act was passed. Okay, so let's proceed to the next point. It is, what are the main provisions of the act? So firstly, the act extends to the whole of Assam. In the whole districts, in the whole of Assam, in every district of Assam, this act was extends. Okay, next is, any local authority may introduce compulsory primary education to whole or any part of the area within its jurisdiction. For this, majority of the 2/3 of its members should support the proposal. Okay, so in Assam, anybody or any person may, or any local authority, need to introduce compulsory primary education. They can introduce that whole or any part of Assam within this act jurisdiction, and for this, majority of the 2/3 of its members should support the proposal. Means the proposal should be supported by the members of the act. Okay, nextly, that is, for compulsory primary education for the children of 6 to 11 years age group should be considered. So the age group for making primary education compulsory is under 6 to 12 years age. Okay, nextly, the local authority should provide 1/3 of the additional cost for primary education and shall levy an educational tax. Okay, the local education need to give 1/3 of the additional cost, okay, of for primary education, and shall levy on education tax. And like education tax, they have to pay the 1/3 of the cost of their primary education. If they want to compulsory the primary education in their state, in Assam, in any specific area or any part of Assam, the local authority should give 1/3 of the educational cost. Okay, nextly, the government shall provide 2/3 of the additional cost of education to the local authorities. Okay, 1/3 will given by the, actually 1/3 need to give by the locality, and the 2/3 of the cost was given by, or the government shall provide that. Okay, nextly, the local authority and the education committee shall be responsible for the enforcement of the act. Okay, the local authority and the education community shall be responsible for the enforcement of the act. If the act need to enforce for future, and for enforce the act, or improvement of the educational conditions of this act, the local authority and the education committee shall responsible. Okay, and shall provide accommodation, equipment, and appointment of education staff on the approval of director of public instruction. Based on the director of public instruction, okay, the local authority and the education committee should provide accommodation, equipment, and appointment of educational staff under this act. Okay, Next major point that is, if a local authority fails to submit a scheme for introducing compulsory primary education within a reasonable time, the government may call upon for compel them to do so. Okay, I think you understand this point. Nextly, the government may notify to make rules to carry out the purposes of this act, particularly about the education tax, constitution of the education committee, and the maintenance of education funds. Okay, the government need to notify to make rules to carry out the purposes of the act. The government actually makes some rules to carry out of this act, particularly about the education, regarding educational tax, regarding constitution of the education committee, actually what are the activities done by the education committee, government will make some rules, and the maintenance of the educational fund and how to maintain the educational funds. So regarding these three major points, the committee actually government makes some rules. Okay, so this is so important, so in what factors actually, so you keep these things as note. Okay, nextly, no tuition fees shall be charged from any people of recognized school maintained or aided by the local authority. If the school is aided by or maintained by the local authority, students not need to pay any tuition fees. Okay, poor children will be provided with books and writing materials free of cost by the local authority if the education committee recommends. If the education committee recommend, then the local authority actually provides books and other writing materials in free of cost to the poor children of the specific state under this act. Okay, next, there is no next point, so we stop here for today, because these are some 10 points and I think these points are very easy, and these points are actually focuses towards the main provisions of this act, and under these points we can learn different the actually what is the act and what are the circumstances under this act. We will learn it in our next class. Okay, so till that, thank you, and if you have any problem then you can ask me, or if you want to put some notes specifically, then you can put actually keep the notes, because different types of question will arise in your examination in between from the course. Okay, in between.